the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we gather together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sin and so prepare to celebrate. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorification of your Christ and the light of the Holy Spirit have unlocked for us the gates of eternity, grant, we pray, that partaking of so great a gift, our devotion may grow deeper and our faith be strengthened. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. King Agrippa and Bernice arrived in Caesarea on a visit to Festus. Since they spent several days there, Festus referred Paul's case to the king, saying, "There is a man here left in custody by Felix. When I was in Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and demanded his condemnation. I answered them that it was not Roman practice to hand over an accused person before he has faced his accusers and had the opportunity to defend himself against their charge. So when they came together here, I made no delay. The next day I took my seat on the tribunal and ordered the man to be brought in. His accusers stood around him, but did not charge him with any of the crimes I suspected. Instead, they had some issues with him about their own religion and about a certain Jesus who had died, but who Paul claimed was alive. Since I was at a loss how to investigate this controversy, I asked if he were willing to go to Jerusalem and stand trial on these charges. And when Paul appealed that he be held in custody for the emperor's decision, I ordered him held until I could send him to Caesar." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, you mighty in strength, to do his bidding.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had revealed himself to his disciples and eaten breakfast with them, he said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." He then said to Simon Peter a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Simon Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." He said to him, tend my sheep. He said to him a third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was distressed that he had said to him a third time, do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. Amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he had said this, he said to him, follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a lot in this gospel to reflect on. First of all, we see the threefold affirmation of Peter to coincide with how Peter denied Jesus three times. We see in the gospel today that relationship is restored with the affirmation, do you love me, three times. But it's also good to note that Jesus doesn't hold that denial over Peter, but rather he chooses Peter to lead his church. And we need to remind ourselves that we, like Peter, deny Jesus, but our relationship can be restored through the sacrament of reconciliation, through our confession, and Jesus doesn't hold our sins over our head, but he's quick to forgive. And we need to remind ourselves of that, because sometimes we are so unwilling to forgive ourselves. And then at the end, he says to Peter, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will dress you. The stretching out of hands signifies that Peter too will be crucified on the cross. But we also look at that image, isn't that what happens to us as we get older? We need someone to hold on to us. We need someone to help us get dressed. And it reminds us that we too are going to die. But we shouldn't be afraid of death. Because as people of faith, we know that Jesus destroyed sin and death by dying and rising. And that death is just the gateway to our home, eternal life in heaven. So we follow the example of Peter. We should take comfort that, yes, we're not perfect, but Jesus is willing to forgive our imperfections if we ask for forgiveness. And it's up to us, through our actions, to live out the gospel message for all peoples to see. With praise and thanksgiving, let us present our petitions. For the church, the body of Christ here on earth, may the Lord grant us patience for one another, bearing with one another in love and humble and gentle hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations for the priesthood, religious life, and permanent diaconate, especially from our parishes. In a special way, we remember Kevin Holland and Joe Patrone, who will be ordained to the priesthood of Jesus Christ this afternoon. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, in a special way, we remember Josephine Dean. As we've embraced our loved ones in this life, may God embrace them in eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all creation, we come before you this day. Hear our petitions and grant them according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human beings. Come for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice in you may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look mercifully, O Lord, we pray, upon the sacrificial gifts of your people, and that they may become acceptable to you. Let the coming of the Holy Spirit cleanse our consciences through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy. Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all goods. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Lawrence our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, and as we await the blessed and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins, but on faith in your truth, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called for the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. O God, by whose mysteries we are cleansed and nourished, grant, we pray, that this banquet which you give us may bring the everlasting life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just thank you for tuning in and praying with us this morning. Just a reminder, today's Friday, we have confessions from 4:30 until 5. Also, this afternoon, via live stream on Facebook, will be the priesthood ordinations of Joe Patron and Kevin Holland. So please tune in. They will take place at St. Mark's Seminary again this afternoon at 4 o'clock. On Monday, June 1st, this Monday, we begin our regular Mass. We resume our regular Mass schedule with public Masses. I'm going to do a video. It'll be probably posted later today or tomorrow at the latest. I would encourage everyone to watch the video. It'll be on our Facebook page, it'll be on our web page, explaining how the process will go if you come to public Mass and what is required of you. You know, we've heard a lot about, is the church going to be clean? Well, it's a two-way street. We all need to do our part. So please, if you could spread the word about we're resuming public Masses, also have people watch the video, and if they're not able to watch it, if you watch it, explain what they need to do. Also, we will continue live streaming. Live streaming Masses will be during the week at 12:10, and then on weekends we will do the 4 o'clock Saturday and the 8:30 on Sunday. So starting Monday, tomorrow we'll still, and Sunday we'll live stream 7:30, but beginning Monday it will be the 12:10 Mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.